Good morning, students. Welcome back to the English Channel Prime for grade 8. Students, in the last class, we have completed the explanation of the chapter Prose 6, that is, The Model Millionaire. So, in this chapter, in this class, we are going to give the exercises and the grammars that follow. In this lesson, we have grammars like the prefixes, suffixes, the homonyms, the compound words, etc. So I'll explain all this while doing the exercise. So let's start with the comprehension. The first main, answer the following questions in two or three sentences each. Question number one, what sort of man was Huey Erskine? Answer is, Huey Erskine was a good-looking young man. He was liked and admired by men and women alike. He was not very clever and never had any money. Question number two, what were the various jobs he took up and why? Answer, Huey was always changing his job because he was not successful in any of them. He worked on the stock exchange for 6 months. He started selling tea and then sherry. He failed in all his efforts. Question number three. What was the condition laid down for Huey to marry Laura? Answer is, Laura's father, a retired colonel, put a condition for the marriage of Huey and Laura. He asked Huey to earn £10,000 of his own and then come to him with the proposal of marriage. Question number four. Who was Alan Trevor? What was Alan Trevor doing when Huey called on him? Write down the answer. Alan Trevor was a painter. He was giving final touches to the life-size painting of a beggar when Huey called on him. Question number five. How was the model beggar dressed? Answer. The beggar was dressed in torn, dirty clothes. He had a ragged brown coat over his shoulder. His boots were patched and well worn. Question number six. What did Huey feel the model should get and why? Answer. Huey felt that the beggar model should get a part of what Alan earned after selling his picture. In his opinion, the beggar had also been working as hard as Alan. Question number seven. Why did Huey feel sorry for the beggar man? Answer. The beggar was an old man, bent and wrinkled, with a piteous look on his face. He looked sad and lonely. Done. Question number eight. What did Huey give the old beggar man? Answer. Huey gave the beggar man a sovereign. That means a gold coin worth 1 sterling. Question number 9. What did Alan Trevor tell Huey when he met him at the Pallet Club? Answer. Alan told Huey that the beggar model was Baron Hosberg, one of the richest men in Europe. The Baron had a house in every capital city and ate food in gold plates. He had so much money that he could buy all of London. Question 10. Alan says he will invest your sovereign for you, Huey. How do you think the Baron could have invested the sovereign for Huey? Answer. The Baron might have a number of business firms of his own. He could invest Huey's money in one of his companies and earn profits. Next, second main, answer the following questions in 5 or 6 sentences each. That means we have to write long answers for these questions. Second main, question number one. That old beggar, as you call him, is one of the richest men in Europe. Name the richest man referred to. How is he described to Huey? Answer. The richest man's name was Baron Hosberg. He had a house in every capital city. He ate his food in gold plates. He could buy all of London the next day and prevent Russia from going to war. He was very influential and powerful. He had a desire to get his picture painted as a beggar. He had asked Alan to paint his portrait and offered to pose as the beggar model himself. Done? Let's write down question number 2. Describe how Huey was able to marry Laura Merton. Answer: Huey was a handsome young man. He was not intelligent and did not have any money. He tried to make money by doing different jobs, but failed in his attempts. He was deeply in love with Laura. Laura's father told him that he would consider giving his daughter in marriage if he earned £10,000 of his own. One day, Huey saw a beggar model in Alan Trevor's studio. He mistook him for a real beggar and gave him a sovereign. The beggar model was in reality a rich man by name Baron Hosper. He was impressed by Huey's generosity. He found out everything about Huey from Alan Trevor. He sent Huey a check for £10,000 as a wedding present. Thus, Huey was able to marry Laura. Done. Question number 3. Bring out the subtle humor in the story, The Model Millionaire. Answer is, the whole story has an undercurrent of subtle humor. Huey attempts to work and earn money. When he fails at everything, he gives up his efforts. He decides to live on a meek allowance given to him by an old aunt. These things evoke humorous reaction in the readers. And Huey's conversation with Alan Trevor is also very humorous. Without knowing the real identity of the beggar model, Huey gives him the only sovereign he had. When he comes to know that the beggar is Baron Hosberg, he thinks he has made a fool of himself. Alan's jokes about Huey's generosity are hilarious. Baron Hosberg's reaction when Huey gives him the sovereign, his benevolent nature, and the way in which he sends the wedding present are all examples of subtle humor in this story. Done? Question number 4. I have got heaps of old clothes at home. Do you think you would like any of them? Why, his rags were falling to bits, said Huey. But he looks so wonderful in them, said Trevor. I wouldn't paint him in a good suit for anything. However, I'll tell him of your offer. So the above instance is an example of subtle humor. Pick out the other incidents of humor from this story. Children, we just discussed. So let's write down the answer. First one, he had been a tea merchant but soon got tired of selling tea. So this is quite humorous. Second point, Laura loved him very much and together they made a handsome couple. Of course, neither of them had any money. Again, this is also a joke-like. Third point, the old man jumped and a faint smile crossed his lips. Fourth point, good heavens, I gave him a sovereign. Fifth one, he will invest your sovereign for you and pay you interest. So this is all quite humorous in this story. Now let's do the vocabulary. Third main A, compound words. Children, as you know, if two different words put together to form a new word, it is called a compound word. Like bedroom. Bed has a separate meaning, room has a separate meaning, but when they are together, that gives a completely new meaning. So bedroom, beggar man, newspaper, or you can say footmarks, grandmother, all these are called the compound words. So let's look at the first question. Fill in the blanks given below with the help of the compound words. Dash picture, children, already it is given in the bracket, so you can write as full size picture. Dash young man, yes, good looking young man. The old dash beggar man. The frame maker wanted to speak to Trevor. Frame maker is again another compound word. Second question, match the words in column A with the words in column B to make more compound words. As I said, we can make grand, yes, grandmother. Second, news, newspaper. Third, mile, milestone. Fourth one, bookmark. Fifth one, tiebreaker. Sixth one, yes, footpath. Done. Let's do the affixes. Children, there are two types of affixes. Affixes means it can be either prefix or a suffix. Prefix means a word which does not have a meaning by itself, but when it adds to the beginning of a word, to the starting of a word, that forms a new word. The new word is very often, mostly it used to be the opposite of the root word. For example, if I'll say kind, if we'll put one affix un, then it will become unkind. He never said an unkind word to anyone. So here, un is the prefix and it makes the word kind to exactly opposite by putting this un. So kind, unkind, like, dislike, or connection, disconnection. So these, if you'll add the prefix, it will become the exact opposite of the root word or the first word. So use appropriate prefixes to the words given below to form words opposite in meaning by using dish, miss, or on. So let's do. The first one is given do. So we can add on to make it the opposite, like do, undo, broken, yes, unbroken, clean, unclean, respect, disrespect, regard, disregard, like, dislike, wanted, unwanted, honor, dishonor, comfort, discomfort, honest, dishonest, obey, disobey, appear, disappear, agree, disagree, content and discontent. So these are the prefixes that gives when it is added to the root word, it gives the exact opposite meaning. Now let's do the second one, suffixes. Suffixes means again the same, but it is used at the end of a word. A word which does not have a meaning by itself, but when added to the end of a word, forms a new word. That is, it forms a new word. It doesn't give the opposite. Example, full. Then you can write, what a wonderful model it is. I think it is dreadful. So, full is the suffix. Wonderful, dreadful are the new words. We can add many types of suffixes like less, full, ish, ness, etc. Let's see. Use appropriate suffixes to the words given below to form the new words. So easy can be written as easily. Ly is the suffixes. Hope, hopeful, full, foolish, brown, brownish, calm, calmly, help, helpful, or you can write helpless, pain. Again, you can add full or less, painless or painful, child, childish, use, useful, beauty, beautiful, doubt, doubtful, slow, slowly or slowness, cheer, cheerful, cheerless, color, colorful, colorless, all these are the suffixes that can be added. Next is third, homonyms. Children, homonym means a word which has the same sound, same spelling, but has two different meanings. That means it can have the same spelling and same sound also, pronunciation, but has different meaning. Like you can say right, right, right direction, and whatever is correct is also called right. Okay, trip, trip, trip means when you stamp, fell down, that is a trip, and when it is a journey, that is also called trip, T-R-I-P, same spelling, same pronunciation, but with a different meaning. For example, here one example is given, model, a person or thing that has an excellent example of a quality, that is called model, like Gandhiji is the model of sacrifice. Or again, model can be used, a copy of something. There is a model of the Taj Mahal made of marble. So these are called the homonyms. So let's do the third one. Construct sentences with the following homonyms to bring out two different meanings of each word. We have to frame sentences to give out two different meanings. So trip, first one you can write, he tripped and fell down. Second one you can write, they went on a trip to Belur. So both the meanings are different. Next is stamp, he pasted a stamp on the envelope. Second, Sam stamped his foot in anger. Third one, plant, we must plant trees to save our environment. And second, there are a number of medicinal plants in this garden. So plant is used as two with two different meanings. Right, right. This is not the right way to do things. Second one, you can write, take a right turn at the intersection. So this is also having two different meanings. These are called the homonyms. Write any four homonyms which have different meanings with the help of a dictionary. Yes, children, you can write bank, bank. That means bank is one hour where money is deposited, and another, the river side, the river bank. Bow, bow, B-O-W, which has a meaning like the arrow and bow, and the bow, bowing means bent down. Object, object. Object means pigeons or the persons of a city or persons of a place, and object meaning things. Okay. So these things, these words you can write like advance, bank, bow, object, play, bear, lie, fly, ring, lift, type, fine, etc. Next is pawn. Children, pawn meaning a type of wordplay. In a pawn, a homonym is used in the same sentence to mean two different things to give more artistical value to the poem or to the writing. Like great writers like William Shakespeare, Oscar Wilde and others often used pawn, that means the homonyms, to add fun and flavor to their writing. So look at the last line of this lesson and explain the pawn. So we can look at this last sentence. The last sentence of the lesson is, remarked Alan, our millionaire models, remarked Alan, are rare enough, but model millionaires are rarer still. So what does it mean? Yes, it means the word model is used to mean two different things. Despite being a millionaire, Baron Hausberg wished to be portrayed as a beggar and offered to be the model himself. Later, he proves himself a model millionaire, an ideal for other millionaires, by helping Huey. So these here, the homonym model and model is used to give two different meanings. Done, children? Dictionary work is given. Make 5 pairs of pun words with the help of the dictionary. So you can write first sentence. After taking a shot with his bow, the archer took a bow. B. No one could believe how much produce our garden could produce. C. There is simply no use for something you cannot use. D. The rebel seized the opportunity to rebel. E. The incense incensed the customers. So here, children, you can look at bow or believe, use, rebel, incense, etc. are used as the homonym with two different meanings. These are called the pawns. Fifth main, color in language. Study this sentence. You told that old beggar all my private affairs, cried Huey, looking very red and angry. So here the word red is used to describe a feeling of anger. Colors are often associated with various types of emotions. So in this question, we have to select a color from the box to describe the feelings associated with them and then fill in the blanks with the colors. The old lady seemed to be in the dash of health. So you can write in the pink of health, means in the good health. Second, John was dashed with envy when he heard that his friend would be meeting the Prime Minister in person. Means green. Green means jealous. Salini became dashed with anger when Anjali shared her secret with other girls. Became red. Red is the shows the mood of anger. We must cheer him up. He was feeling dashed all day. He was feeling, yes, you can write, he was feeling grey all day, not feeling good. Okay. The cop beat him up, dash and dash. Yes, meaning black and blue. We used to make it more often. Sixth one, the stallion breed was as pure, as dash in color, as white in color. That means it shows the purity, the honesty. Done. Next is sixth main, learn to speak and listen. Children, enact the story in small groups. We'll do this in the classroom itself. Second one also, create a dialogue for the following roles and present it before your class. This one also we'll do as a speaking activity, as we did in the last class for lesson for Nakul. Like that. C. Identify the following characters from the lesson. Children, try to identify. I am a very good looking young man, liked and admired by both men and women. Who is this? Can you identify? Yes, this is Huey Erskine. I am a girl, daughter of a retired colonel. Who is this? Yes, Laura Merton. Third one, I am a strange man with a red beard, a very clever artist. Yes, who is this? Alan Trevor. Fourth one, I am an old man, bent and wrinkled, with a piteous look on my face. Yes, who is this? The beggar mother. Fifth one, I am the richest man in Europe who could buy all London. I have a house in every capital city. Yes, children, who is this? This is Baron Hausberg. So all these answers you said correctly, and hope all these things you understand. Thanks for watching, children.